But this is a big week, folks. We've got Justice Alito. We've got this case in Pennsylvania. They have to make give a response. The parties involved, I think, by tomorrow morning. We've got Michigan. Jenna Ellis is out there saying, look, we have been given by a judge access to basically analyze 22 of these voting machines. Apparently going to take 48 hours to do an investigation. And then, of course, we have tomorrow is supposed to be what they refer to as the Safe Harbor Day, where the electors are officially chosen. The electors are supposed to vote on December 14th. This is the week that a lot of things are going to have to happen. They absolutely have to begin happening. And I think we can see the dominoes stacking up, and we'll see which direction those dominoes fall. But the idea that these jokers think that they're just going to ignore this, we've reached a boiling point in this nation. There is no more just ignoring this. I don't think that's possible. Now, they may in their minds make the calculation, hey, look, we can rig elections now. Who cares what people think? So I don't like to say this, but part of me really thinks that these are conversations being had by people in positions of power. They can see the finish line. They just need to flip a couple Senate seats in Georgia. And if they can do that, which, of course, they've already done. I mean, it's very clear to me that there's something incredibly nefarious going on in these states. If they can just continue down this path, they have complete control of both houses of the legislature in D.C. and the presidency, even though Biden's out there chasing his dog by the tail and breaking his foot.